everybody, and welcome back for a new video. As you already noticed, probably, I am not on MineLink today, and that is because it's currently down. I don't know why it's down. I haven't really searched into it on the forums and stuff like that. All I know is that it is down. And I've now waited quite a lot of time. Now it's 2 in the morning, and I just can't wait for it to get up any longer. So I'm here on OneShot MC, and today I am gonna try to do something that I've been asked to do in the comments, and that's just to make the cannon. And they ask how I can just throw down some blocks and then make it a cannon, and you guys want to be able to do that. So I'm gonna start up slow here, and I'm gonna go as slow as possible, but if I'm basically just gonna make the cannon, I'm not gonna make the sand compression, since that was not really the question mark here. People rather want me to just do the cannon. So before you start up, you gotta choose what block you want to build it out, and I'm just gonna use cobble. You can use whatever you want. The next thing you have to do is to figure out how high you want your barrel, and of course the higher it is, the more you can lower the shot. And the higher it is, the more you need to stack as well. The normal one is 5 blocks, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then goes like this. That is, I think that's basic, like normal. It could go 6, it could go 7, but 5 is more normal. After you've done this, you can go ahead and you can build this out a little bit more, just so it doesn't look that small. Like this. So now that you've done that, the first thing you'll see on the cannon is the booster, or the hammer booster. So the hammer booster all depends on how long you want your hammer to be. So let's say at this point you can choose between 1 stacker to 255. So it's really up to you what you want to make. Today I've decided to make a 60 stacker. Yeah, let's just say a 60 stacker. I'm not going to go bigger because that's a lot of free dispensers and such, and it's quite early here in the morning. But you can use this exact same concept to make whatever cannon you want. It is just a simple question of the right booster. It's probably almost the same takes all the way too. So now that you got this, you need to figure out the booster. And of course, the booster as well as the hammer down has to be 2 up like this. So let's just do it. It doesn't really have an amount. I'm just going to do this. I'll remove some of it later. When we get there, I'll just make it quite long here, just so you have the space to build on. The next thing you need to do is to get some dispensers out. This is going to be your booster for your hammer down. So you can compress all that, and I kind of like to do this like this. You can do it however you want it, or you can just follow what I do here. Of course, at this point, all depending on how long you want your hammer down, you can even go further with this, and you can make a booster. So it will, like, this one boosts this one as well, so this one blows up, it moves some of the hammer down, and this right here will end right here and explode, and then move the rest of the way. But today I don't think we're gonna go much into that. I will probably do that in a later episode if you guys like this video here. If it gets enough views, I might actually just go around and let you know of different kinds of boosters and stuff like that. But today is we're just gonna do this. You don't really need that much TNT there, but you can easily change that yourself. Now that we've done that, remember always to use glass as much as you can. So let's go ahead and just add out glass again. We're gonna remove some of these, so don't put too much. There we go. After you've done that, you're gonna need to put some kind of roof on this. So let's do it like this. And let's actually fill this in here so it looks more like a barrel. There we go. After you've done that, you will probably know that the hammer down goes one block after, so you'd have a block of air right here. So let's just go ahead and put cobblestone on top of this. You can make the hammer down all the way down here. That's not an issue. You can even make it all the way down here if that's what you want. It's really up to you guys what you want to do with your cannon. I just kind of want the space in between there just to get a little bit more space. So now we need to figure out how long we want our hammer down. And then of course that's based on the booster we have here. It won't be able to push more than 7 blocks, so we'll have to figure out what we're going to do. And even at 7, the 7th TNT over there is not nearly getting moved. So let's see here. Let's do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And of course we have 5 and end. Is this long enough or do we want an 5, 6. Yeah, 6 blocks. Doubt that. Nah, let's do this because it's only a 60 stack. I just reminded myself that. But let's go ahead and do that. So we need to go around like this. Now, of course, you don't really need to make the hammer down like this. You can have the booster boosting it in from this side here or the other side. Or you can have it from underneath the cannon and boost it up. But when you move the hammer down to the side, then remember that it's not realigned to the other side. And I'll be going more into that later if you guys enjoyed this video here. But let's just fill this in here. We don't really need that right now. And again, we don't really need this. So let's fill that in like this. And of course, we can use glass right here just so we can see too what's going on. Right here, we have the last block right here. And that this is where the TNT goes. So let's have our piston. Let's have our piston right under here. Like this. Then of course we can get rid of this now. We don't really need that now. So let's get rid of that. That was mine a little bit too long there. But if you boost this now, the TNT will bypass this. It wouldn't stop here. It will simply just go this way here. We don't really want that, so we're going to put up blocks here. Let's just flatten that out as well. So now, when you use this booster here, it will go ahead and will push all this into this block right here. And then it will push it out into the barrel. And hopefully we will get some hammer down out. After we've done this, the next one that comes after the hammer down here. Let's just do this real quick. There we go. So next thing you want to think about adding, of course, the sand and the slab bust. So it's really up to you what you want to do first. You can add the slab bust now, or you can add the slab bust after the sand, or the sand first and the slab bust. You can even attach a nuke to it. You can do a lot of possibilities when building your own cannon that you wouldn't be able to get on my cannons that I release, unless you, of course, ask in the comments. But what I'm think we're gonna do today now is have the slab bust first. And of course the slab bust goes on the same, so it goes two up like this, and then we need the slab bust. And we need the slab bust right here. Alright. And then before you do this, you have to think that you need the red sand in somehow. And the way I like to have the red sand in is just to do like this. And then put block there. And then we can use this one for the red sand. And of course we will need this piston here to be wired, so it will push in the sand here. And we're gonna need one more piston here like this to push it that way. It is possible to simply just have it right here. I've done that on cannons as well. So let's do this for a difference, for a change. So let's get rid of that, and then we can put it up here. Redstone everything up from here, so we won't have an issue. So let's do something different today. After that, you can go ahead and you can build this up here. We don't really need that. The next one is going to be the sand, which is right next to the slab bust. So let's build that up as well. There we go. Let's make that a platform right there. And of course, right here with the slab bust is, you're going to have full box on the other side. like this, and of course you're going to leave the hole for the slap boss. Slap boss is probably going to be something like right here. There we go. You can't really have it here. It's going to be a little bit hard to stun up. It is possible, but for you beginners here, I wouldn't recommend having it here because you can't really put a repeater here. It's going to redstone the block, dispenser block, and dispenses some of the hammer down as well. So if you just do it to start with, this is just fine. So let's put glass up and protect it from other redstone that might happen in that area. After that, right here where we have our sand, of course we don't want it to shoot all the way this way. That's not really going to help us. So we're going to need sand here as well, like this. And of course you can either choose to have your TNT Relana here and then the boost, then the power, or you can even shrink it one more in to have... It was an automatically restart of the server. I thought that would go down. But as we were here, of course you can keep this line, or you can have the TNT corrector go here and like this, or you could just simply have the TNT corrector there and do like this, but I like it kinda in here, so I don't mind having it there. And now you need to figure out how much power you want. Normal, you don't put more than the one single booster can push, so that's 6 or 7 blocks. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's do a number 6 here. So that's going to be 6 long. Let's go ahead and wire that up like this. Right here you want a full block as well. I'm going to use cobblestone here just to smoothen it out like this. Alright. I might need glass here. There we go. And of course we need to stack this one up as well. So let's stack that 4 up. Maybe 5 up. Oh, what happened there? After we've done that, we have a good way. So we need, again, every single time we put a booster, we need a block in between. Then we can put the block in between right here. And let's just make it like this. After we've done that, of course, we need to wire this up as well. We need to wire this up as well. So let's do like... like that. No, that can't be done. Let's see here how we can do this. Like that. And then put a redstone here. And this one goes on 2 ticks or 3 ticks. This one goes on a 4 repeater. And have it like that. Of course, now they're going to be on the same tick like this. Perfect. And of course, this sand here is going to be on down on that piston there, because this piston pushes way before this one. This is on 3 ticks, so that means that this one pushes 3 ticks after, then this pushes the sand out, so it should work perfectly. After that, you need to figure out how you're going to wire your power up. That's different ways to do it. The one I like personally is putting it up like this. And of course, this is what you do on all your... all of them, and then in the meantime just wire that up as well. But when you do like me, I put blocks here, repeater on, and then slaps, or you can just simply just do slap 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 slap. It's probably easier if I show you something like this. But again, when you have schematic on and you try to print this in, it's kind of getting kind of difficult, so I like to use full blocks like this. It kind of helps with the schematic. And I like printing in my cannons when I raid. I really can't be asked to place every single block. Normally I just do it off my mind and then everything works out. But let's go ahead and use this method. Makes it a little bit easier for you guys that is printing cannons in. So let's go ahead and wire that up. We need gonna need the other side as well here while we add it. I like using the same way, so this one on the corner is a full block, then I'll do a full block over here as well. I don't know, I just like that, I just like the view of it better than the other one. Don't ask me why, but there's not really a big difference between it. There we go. Let's add slap to this as well. Actually, let's add repeaters first. There we go. I don't even remember if I wired everything up here. Did I put repeaters and everything? Yeah, I did. There we go. Let's put that up like this. There we go. Now that we've done that, we're gonna need to wire this one up as well. So let's wire this up like this. After we've done that, we're gonna need two fold repeaters on here. Again, this is something you can edit yourself in your own Canon. You can do one fold repeater, you can do two fold repeaters. It's really up to you. I just like using two here. And of course, I can go into much more details about why I do that. But if you guys like this video here, just let me know, and I will do another video. Now that we've done this, we're gonna need to connect the booster here, and there's a different ways to connect the booster. The easiest way when doing this, there's a variety of ways to do it. You can either do it like this and then wire it like that, or you can do this right here like this, and then whenever you press this one, it will ignite all of them. Of course, you need a Western RP as well. So this is one of the ways you can do it. There's way many ways to do this, and I might actually do a video where I show you all the ways to do this in this kind of form where there's like dispensers here and dispensers here. It's really up to you guys, and it can really like help smoothing out your Canon. So it's a good thing to know what you can do. But today we're just gonna leave it like this. After you've done that, you basically have everything out that you need. Of course, we need to go ahead and fix this as well. So let's go ahead and do that. And this is 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's 10. That means that we need this one up as well. There we go. That's 20. 30. Oops. This is 40. This is 50. And 50. There you go. Let's put these up. Alright, so now it's 5 high. That means that this is 50. And with these here, these here together, that is 10. So that is 60. You need a little bit more than 60. So let's put it one more layer up. You don't really need to put a full layer up, all depending on your slab boss as well. But let's just have it like this. It's a good. Yeah, I kind of like this. The next thing you're going to do is you got to figure out how you want this. I'm going to do something like this. It looks like that is working just fine. Right here, I'll actually show you that here in a second. Right here, we can have it like this. That is just fine. And you can actually, if I show you here, if you have it like this, you won't be able to do anything with this redstone here. But if you move it one block up, the same high Y level as the repeater, that means that the repeater takes into this dispenser. This dispenser block dispenses redstone out to this one here. So that's where you'll be able to ignite this line here. So let's do this all the way up here. And as well as the other side here, you won't be able to do it down here because it's not overlined with it. But if you move it up, then it will work perfectly. So let's go ahead and add that line up as well. There we go. And nobody says you have to put full hammer down on both sides. You can just have glass on one side. There's really like a million possibilities when making cannons. And that's kind of what I like doing with it. I like experimenting with it and then actually get a cannon out of it. Nothing that I'm going to release or anything. I'm basically going to release all the like normal cannons that people make. I just make my own design and then release it for you guys. But I have some crazy ass cannons. I have like where the hammer and slab bust and everything is like separate, goes into one big core and then it gets shotted out. It's hard to explain, but I got a lot of stuff I just play around with. But let's just go ahead and wire the last thing up here. And again, I'm going to go on the other side here just to make sure I'm doing it correct, like this. And of course, we don't need to wire these sides here anymore. So we can go ahead and have a small amount of redstone on this side here, which as well will smoothen out this side here. So it doesn't look that messy. And that is kind of what I'm going for here. I don't want to make it too messy. But my redstone is messy. I know that for a fact. People tell me it is a bit messy, but oh well. I kind of like my way to wire everything up. But now that we've done that, we're basically ready to go ahead and wire this power up. And of course, because our power isn't that high up, we need to lower down. Oh, actually, we don't. I don't think so. Let me see here. Nah, we need to lower it a little bit. Of course, if we had our hammer down higher up, we didn't need to do it like this. But today, I'm just going to do it like this. So, of course, redstone line is just not good enough. You're going to need a repeater very close to the power here, and then you're going to need one that's decent close to this one as well. You can even make it one further, because this repeater here will power the cobblestone will power the redstone, and the redstone will power the hammer down. We're going to put this on two ticks. No. Yeah, let's put two ticks. And we're going to do the same with the other side here. I'm going to try to do it just as we did over there. But again, we need to modify it a little bit. I'm going to tell you that here in a second, why we have to do that. So now that we've got this one up. Oh, I would like to get here, but oh well. Now that we've got that one up, you can either choose to have your comparator to go in here. Just redstone it out like that. But that means that this repeater here is going to gain one tick to the hammer down. We don't want that. We want it to be perfect. So what we need to do is that we need to do this. Then the slab boss will work. And then you can only change this one. So we don't really want that. So this one here is out of the picture. What we want to do is that we want to somehow to get a comparator to redstone this up here. And then the same way attached to this one right here. And that can get a little bit difficult, especially because you can't do this. So what we need to do is actually move this one more out. You don't really have to do it my way. You can do it just around what you want to do. It's really not my decision how you want to do this. But I kind of wanted like not having to change only one repeater. I want to be able to have full control of all the repeaters that are on this cannon. So again, we're gonna add two ticks. Did I add two ticks? Yeah, I did. So now we have a little bit more space here we can work on, and we can actually get something started here. So the way you can do this is you can put a repeater, sorry, comparator there and comparator there. If you do it like this, then you are prepared for adding more slab bust or dispensers or up. But there's other ways to do it. When you only want to wire power these, you can go ahead and you can just wire differently. But today we're going to do it like this, so everybody will be able to follow along. And if you want to add more slab bus, you can do that if you want to. But now that we added this here, the hammer down is working 100%. We're basically done. All we need to do is figure out what we're going to do with these pistons here, because of course we want everything to go out as well. And before I actually forget it, let's build a scatter here. The scatter can go anywhere actually in the cannon, but try to make it on this side of the cannon. But let's just make a small scatter here. It's a small cannon, so we don't really need much. So let's just do it like this. This is just fine. That's OCD. There we go. And after we've done that, you can go ahead and you can see that it is one underground there and one up here. That means that both of these dispensers are touching this cobblestone right there. So let's go ahead and see what happens if we do this. If we then ignite this into the cobblestone will ignite both this dispenser and the dispensers over there. So that's a little trick there for you guys as well. The next thing we can do is that we can go one out like this, or we can even go one in like this. But the question is how many repeaters we're going to need and how long the power is. Of course, if you're going to have more than, or if you have exactly right here, you won't be able to do it. There's a lot of questions about, or actually, well, myth or whatever you say about how many repeaters you need. You need either 9 or 10, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So let's go ahead and try 9 first. As you see, it's getting very, very compact now. And this is, of course, without the sand compression, so take away of that as well. But let's go ahead and see if we can get this bad boy started up. Of course, your boost or your hammer booster here will be activated. with your sound compression, because that comes first and so does the boosters. But let's see if we can make something up. This is of course not a legit redstone for what you want to do for your cannon. I'm simply just doing this to show that the cannon actually works as well. So let's put a lever here like this, and then maybe put a button at the top for firing it. So why I'm putting a lever is because I want to see how long the whetstone extends. I could count it, but to be honest, I'm a little bit lazy, so I'm not going to do that. But let's turn this off again. Let's just wait for that. It looks like it worked perfectly. Of course, we're going to have some red sand there. But let's go ahead and TNT fill it here, and let's see if we can get something out of it. See if everything is working properly. Alright, that did not work properly. So let's go ahead and put a little bit more repeaters on this. Let's add one more to that one. There we go. Let's add 10. There you go. And you literally need between 9 and 10, so it's not really that... Oh, what happened there? What happened there? Let us see, quickly see here. Oh, it doesn't reach. Alright. So let's go ahead and do this. Just put one in each line here, just to make sure everything works. But now, yep, now it's getting powered. Oh, there's a wet sand. We can just quickly destroy that. There we go. Let's try that again. See if everything goes out as planned. No, we need a slab as well. The slab goes to stop the main power here from going out. We put it where the sand is coming, because then you can break the sand if something goes wrong with the cannon so it doesn't blow up as well. Let's see what's going on now, and this is kind of the final testing on doing this. So what you need to figure out now is what the right ticks are for what you're working on here. And it can be different. It all depending on the ticks you have on your hammer and the ticks you have on your power as well. So it's really not something you can put like no from the beginning, unless you already made the cannon ones. But as you see right there, it looks like this one here was a little bit slow. Normally their booster will go off way before even the cannon starts to fire, which definitely gives us a little bit. But as you see right there, you see that the redstone actually had time to fall down. That means that we had maybe a little bit too many repeaters here. So it's kind of just to time it right, test it out. You can even look at it just to quickly see where everything goes. As you see right there, that is even too many ticks on this one. So let's try with one tick here. Let's see if this is better. It should be better. Oh, almost there. Or you can change some ticks around on the power as well, if you want the power to go a little bit faster than that. But looks like we were out of red sand here. So let's put some more red sand up. There we go. Let's see, like this. There we go. I don't know if you can hear that, but my dog is dreaming right now. Hope he's not running from something. Sometimes I get like a very bad feeling that he's actually having a nightmare and I wake him up. Looks like the cannon is working. Just quickly make sure that the red sand is catching it as well. Let's use this. That's fine for me. I don't want the red sand or something to break as well. So let's see if the red sand makes this as well. Nope, it didn't. So let's figure out what that issue is. Alright, it looks like the booster here is too close to it. Alright, it's getting moved too fast, so let's try and remove some of the booster here. And of course, redstone or red sand can be touched from all over there. I didn't really take height for that when making this cannon here. So you might want to make it a little bit longer than 5 long here. And again, I'm really tired, so I didn't really notice it. That might have been a mistake from my side, guys. But let's TNT fill it again, see if we can find another solution for this problem. But let's go ahead and see what we can do here. We can either time the booster right. And I think we will have to do that. So what we're going to do now is that we're going to time the booster just perfect. But of course, you can make the redstone go, the red sand to go out of range of that booster right there, and then you wouldn't have an issue with it. But of course, I'm too tired to figure that out. But I hope that this helped you guys a little bit, even though I fucked up a little bit here at the end. So I still hope that you guys learned a little bit from this, even though this little fuck up here with the red sand. I didn't even think about it, to be honest, because normally I make very, very big cannons. I don't make small cannons like this, so that's kind of a bummer. It's actually been a long time since I made small cannons. Normally I just take one of the other small cannons I already had, and then simply just make it, simply just like put something on it, like left shoot or whatever it was. So it's been a while since I worked with small cannons, but I'm pretty sure we're just fine. But as you see right now, we could have moved the booster a little bit back, that way we would get a little bit more, help there, not to move the red sand as well. But oh well, you can't win every time. Oh, that's not gonna work. It actually looks like it's not even the power. Actually look like it's getting jumped out too fast here. Let me just see this. I'm a little bit tired here. Let me just make sure that this is what it is. Alright, they're getting shot out way too fast. We need some more delay on it. Or we can just simply do this. Yes, yeah, so that's what I mean. I'm a little bit tired. I should probably not have made this video now. Probably not. But here it is. I'm a little bit tired. That might be a stupid idea. But we got the wet sand stacking now. And as you see, I hope that this one will even give you a little bit of... help here. And now that you see me fixing this issue, you see what the issue is. Right as you saw there, TNT getting stuck on the piston here. Of course, we don't want to be a part of that. So we need to add a little bit more ticks here to make sure that the TNT actually makes it. It did actually make it there, but it's not. I'm not quite happy yet. I could go ahead and add a tick to this one, and I'm pretty sure that will fix the issue. Or maybe one tick is too much. Oh, that was way better. So as you see now, we have a perfect cannon. I'm sorry about my fuck ups here, I'm really, really tired. To check out everything works, you go here and you look at it. You need to make sure that the wet sand doesn't move up. And if you had any wet sand, it would actually be perfect. So let's try that one more time here. There we go. Let's see here. Alright, you see that getting shut up this time? We do not want that. Maybe it could be the hammer down. Let's try to put it on one tick, see if it still does it. Because we especially don't want the sand to fly up. It is still flying up a little bit. It might be because we don't have a sand compression on it. Or it might not be. I can't really tell without a sand compression on it. So to continue this journey, we need a sand compression on this cannon here, because wet sand is a weird thing. It might go up because it doesn't stack enough, So that's one of the problems with. I'm pretty sure I had a problem with one of my straight shoot cannons at one time when you guys commented that, and I added a little bit more hammer down, and that worked just fine. But here you go, here's how to make a cannon, and again, you don't need to make it like I did. There is a million possibilities how to make a cannon, there's a million possibilities how to wire it up. And I'm sorry for my fuck ups here, I'm really tired, but there is a million possibilities. You don't have to have your hammer down right here. You can have it just about anywhere as long as you can find a way to get it to the barrel fast enough before the power goes off. And of course you need it to be on a very big tick so your sand can stack at the right height. But there's really a million possibilities how you can do cannons, and I hope that you guys will experiment with a lot of things, and maybe if you guys are going to use some of these ideas here to build one of your own cannons, send me a Gyaso in the comments or something like that. I would really like to see what you guys get out of this video here. And that's kind of my point in these videos here. I wanna teach as many as you guys to do stuff. Actually, before I cut off this video here, I was working on Fusion here, as you see right here. And I am working on it, and I am testing it, and I'm trying to improve it as well as I can, and then I will be uploading it. But I have a small issue. As many of you guys know, and probably as many not knowing, that slap busting with Fusion is kind of AIDS. But that got me thinking about something. The only time you actually need the slap bust is if you're cannoning something that's not a full block, right? So if the half trapdoor filters, of course you won't be able to slap bust. You can use a crackdown of the slaps, it will work perfectly. And I'm pretty sure about slap filters, I'm not sure about that one, don't catch me on that one. But especially full box, as you see right here, I have slaps at the bottom. And it is slap busting. It is slap busting, stacking, and one-shotting on this one right here. And that is kind of what we want. We want a fusion that can stack, slap, and scatter on one block. And that's what I made here. Even though that the slap bust is on a slap, you only need a full fusion if you're gonna cannon something like trapdoor filters, where it's not really a full block, it's simply just something like this. Of course, when you go in here, the slap bust wall will go right by it and won't even touch it. The same with a slap, you won't be able to touch that as well if you add a slap here. So if you have slap filters or trapdoor filters, you won't be able to do a slap bust with it. But you can crack the slap down there and you will be able to stack just fine. You'll be able to one shot just as fine as it was a normal fusion. And some of you guys might be wondering why I have this right here. And of course you don't need a one shot on a fusion, but I'm trying to see if I can make that TNT take the sand stack a little bit more down and make a bigger hole. So that's something I've been working on. It's probably not going to be on the fusion. We'll see about that. But I think that's just about it for this video here, guys. I know it's been a really long video here, and it does take a long time to make cannons. But I think we got a nice cannon out of it, and I hope that you guys will get a nice cannon out of it as well. If you guys are wondering how to make a sand compression, let me know down in the comments, but it is quite simple how to do that. But if you guys need me to show you, I will do that. I will make a little tutorial, a build tutorial on how to do that. But here's how you do a straight shoot cannon right from scratch, and I hope that you guys learned a little thing or two about this, and I hope that you guys will like this video here and comment down below with your invention using the ideas provided in this video, or just about saying it's a nice video. But as always, subscribe to my channel, guys, and I'm sorry about my fuck-ups on this channel here. I'm really tired. I'm gonna go to bed now. But thank you guys for watching. My name is Dexter, and I'm out.